Now we will discuss the summary of our ceramic matrix composite. So ceramic matrix composite. So as we know that composite consists of two materials. Among those two materials, one should be a ceramic materials. So the reinforcement and matrix. Among those two materials, if one should be a ceramic, then we are going to call this considering that as ceramic matrix composite. So these ceramic matrix composites are highly used for an operating temperatures are in between 800 to 1650 degrees centigrade. If the operating temperature is in between 800 to 1650 degrees centigrade, then we will go for ceramic matrix composites. Now we will discuss about the advantages of ceramic matrix composites. So the advantages. So these ceramic matrix composites are having high tensile and compression strengths. Tensile and compression. These are having high tensile compression and strength. This is due to incorporating of reinforcement materials into the ceramic materials. So the ceramic materials are incorporated with a reinforcement materials. The reinforcement materials might be in any phase. It means those reinforcements might be in fibers or particles or viscous or flakes. So it might be in any form. Due to incorporation of these reinforcement materials, these reinforcement materials will not allow the crack to propagate. So these reinforcement materials are creating obstacles to the cracks, so that the crack is not propagating, so that the life of our ceramic matrix composites is increasing. So due to this, the fatigue life is also very high, and the fracture toughness is also high. So these are the reasons are based on the same thing, incorporation of reinforcement materials. Those reinforcement materials will not allow the crack to propagate, so that it means it is creating obstacles to the crack, so that the life of the component is increasing. It means it can withstand for higher loads or as well as the cyclic loads also. The next one, these materials are having higher thermal resistance. Means it can withstand for higher temperatures also. So along with this, these are having corrosion resistance. It means chemical resistance. If it is exposed to environmental conditions also, these ceramics are not reacting with any chemicals or moistures. So these are having higher corrosion resistance as well as higher chemical resistance. Why? Because these ceramics are not reacting with any chemicals or moistures in the atmosphere. These are having high strength to weight ratio. It means these composites gives high strength with less amount of weight. So with respect to its weight, the strength of the ceramic matrix composites are high. So next, these materials are having high strength. It means high strength at elevated temperatures also. At elevated temperatures. So at elevated temperatures, it means at high strengths also, our components, it means our ceramic matrix materials can withstand. So it means those are having high strength at elevated temperatures also. And these are having high hardness. High hardness, and the main advantage is low weight. So these are the various advantages of ceramic matrix composites. Now we will go for the limitations of ceramic matrix composites. So it means disadvantages. So it requires high melting furnaces or high equipment. It requires high equipment. The next one is complex fabrication or complex manufacturing. So our ceramics are at the melting temperatures of our ceramics are very high. To hold or to maintain those temperatures, so to maintain those materials or to handle those materials at that temperature, it requires high furnaces as well as high equipment, sophisticated equipment. Next, the main disadvantage is difference in coefficient of expansion. Coefficient of thermal expansion. The main disadvantages is due to the difference in coefficient of thermal expansion. Due to these differences, the reinforcement and matrix will not move parallelly. So the matrix material will have different coefficient of expansion, the reinforcement will have different coefficient of expansion. Due to this, internal some amount of thermal stresses will be generated. So due to incorporation of this, thermal stresses are incorporated. So these are the various disadvantages of our composites. Now we will discuss about the matrix materials. So various materials can be used as a matrix material for ceramic matrix composites. They are alumina. So aluminium and alumina, both are different. Here alumina is a ceramic material that can be used as a matrix material. Along with that, calcium alumina silicate. Calcium alumina silicate can be used as a matrix material. Along with that, lithium alumina silicate can also be used as a matrix material. Along with this, the reinforcements are silicon carbide, aluminum oxide. These two, silicon carbide and aluminum oxide, are the commonly used ceramic materials as a reinforcement materials. Along with this, so some amount of carbon can also be used as reinforcement material. This is the summary of ceramic matrix composites. So coming to the applications. So ceramic matrix can be used at any industries, at any place. Only the thing is, those are commonly used for high temperatures. It means these ceramic materials can be used to withstand the components at elevated temperatures. So due to that reason, these are used for rockets as well as in aerospace, which are having high turbines as well as high propulsion units. Good morning everyone. Today we will discuss about carbon-carbon composites. So here in carbon-carbon composites, both the matrix and the reinforcements, both are carbon materials. Here carbon is used as a ceramic material, is used as a matrix material. Similarly, same carbon is used for reinforcement also. Hence, this is considered as carbon-carbon composites. So these carbon-carbon composites are developed for a higher ranges. It means this can be used for a temperatures of around. Ceramic composites are developed specifically for parts that must operate at extreme temperatures. So extreme temperature ranges, it means for high temperature ranges, these are used for operating at elevated temperatures or at high temperatures. So next, these carbon materials are composed for a carbon matrix reinforced with carbon yarn. So yarn is another spiral wound. So these reinforcements are in the form of fabric and one more carbon matrix. So our reinforcements are incorporated into carbon matrix. So both the reinforcement and the matrix both are made up of carbon. Here the carbon yarns can be used as a reinforcement along with that 3D woven fabric. So woven mat can be used as a reinforcement as well as 3D braiding. So for circular things, for circular cross sections, we will go for braidings. Whereas for flat surface or a concave like that structures, then we will go for woven fabrics. If it is a very thin and the structure requirement is very less, then we will go for this carbon yarn fabrics. So depends upon the application, we will use various types of reinforcements. So these all are braidings. So arrangement of fibers, arrangement of carbons in different ways. Here all the carbon fibers are arranged in a spool. So whereas here those are arranged in a mat like our cloth. So it means those are arranged in 0 degrees and 90 degrees and with some orientation. So those are arranged in a schematic, in a particular way. Whereas braiding comes under, it's a cylindrical way. So if you want a cylindrical cross sections, then we will go for 3D braiding structures. Next, carbon-carbon composites meet applications ranging from rockets. So these are highly used in rockets as well as in aerospace. Because of its withstanding capacity at higher temperatures, of their ability to maintain and even increase. So maintain and increase their structural properties. So it means at higher temperatures that can give better properties than the other type of composite materials. For that reason, here these carbon-carbon composites are highly used in robotics and in aerospace industries. So next, advantages of carbon-carbon composites. So carbon-carbon composites can also be called as CC, carbon-carbon composites. So here, the extremely high temperature resistance. So these materials are having high temperature resistance. It means these can withstand a temperature of around between 900 to 2700 degrees centigrade. 1900 to 2700 degrees centigrade. The next advantage is, in the last point we discussed that. So the strength, their ability to maintain as well as increase their structural properties at extreme temperatures. So it means at high temperatures also those properties are increasing. So the same thing, the strength actually increases. So the strength of the composite increases at higher temperatures. Those higher temperatures are up to 1900 degrees centigrade. If the component, the working conditions or the operating conditions are between these conditions, around 1900 degrees centigrade, our material, these CCs, carbon composites, can use a better properties. Next, low creep resistance. So this creep is deformation with respect to constant stresses. So these are having low creep. It means high creep resistance. So low creep means low deformation. It means high creep resistance at high temperatures. So at a high temperature, for constant temperatures. So earlier, in the earlier classes we discussed that the creep due to temperature and constant stresses, our walls are cracked. So at higher temperatures, the cracks will be more. But if we use carbon composites, then those are having low creep. It means low deformation or high creep resistance at high temperatures. The next one is high strength and stiffness. So these carbons are having high strength as well as high stiffness. So it means the deformation with respect to its sulfate is very high for these carbon composites. The next one is low density. So the density of carbon components is very less compared to ceramics as well as metals. So it is having low density or low weight. The weight of the composite or the structure is very less. These are having good resistance to thermal shock. It means at a high temperatures, as from the starting point onward we are discussing that this can be withstand for higher temperatures. So for higher temperatures, it means thermal shocks, this can be easily resistant. It means that can be withstand. So next, so low and tailorable. So tailorable in the sense modifiable. So depends upon the application, we can tailor the coefficient of expansions, the coefficient of thermal expansion. The thermal expansion can be altered. If we want the thermal expansion to be a certain value, that can be achieved by means of this carbon composites. The value can be increased as well as decreased. It means adjustable or tailorable, modifiable. So the value is very less and that can also be adjusted, depends upon the application where we are going to use. The next one is high thermal conductivity. So high amount of heat can be transmitted by means of these composites. So heat, high amount of electrons. So heat as well as electricity can also be passed by means of these carbon composites. So it means it is having high thermal conductivity as well as high electrical conductivity. Next, these are having good abrasion resistance. So it means it is having high wear resistance. So if the components are having rubbing action, so that the material, the dimensional stability, it is having good dimensional stability. The dimension cannot be reduced over a period of time. It means it is having high abrasion resistance as well as fracture toughness. So if the crack is not propagating, then the toughness, it means the fracture toughness can be increased. So here also, by means of carbon fibers, the crack propagation is very less, so that the strength of the component is very high. Next, excellent high temperature durability. So for during high temperatures, so yet elevated temperatures also, it is having high life. So as we know that if the material is exposing to some amount of temperature, the property will be reduced. So that we learnt in production technology. So hot forging is easy compared to cold forging. If we are heating a rod, it means we are supplying heat to the component. It means heating the component, that then it can be easily deformable. Whereas cold working is very tough. It required high strength. Indirectly, it is saying that at higher temperatures, the strength of the components is reducing. So here, these CECs can withstand at higher temperatures also. It means it shows excellent durability, means excellent strength at elevated temperatures or at high temperatures. So these materials can show properties not only in the environmental conditions as well as in inert gases as well as in vacuum environment also. Many of the materials will fail at inert gas conditions, but these carbon composites can withstand for that also. The next one is good corrosion resistance. So our materials are not reactant to atmosphere, so that these are having good resistance to corrosion. The next, applications of carbon composites. So as we discussed that these are having high heat resistant components, so that these are highly used in aerospace as well as in rocket areas. So for that, so these are mostly seen in space shuttle nose. nose cones. So here the nose cone is the starting point of the rocket. So those are exposed to high temperatures during its due to its high velocity. If the rocket is moving with high velocity, then the nose is exposed to wear with the temper with the environmental air, so that the temperature will be very high. To withstand the nose at that temperature, those nose are manufactured with carbon composites. So space shuttle nose cones, the starting nose cones are manufactured with this. So re-entry temperature of this is 3000 Kelvin. So these are used for aircraft brakes. So as we know that brakes are working by means of friction. So due to this friction, high amount of heat will be liberated. At that conditions, our CCs, carbon components can withstand further temperatures. So due to that, so these are used in aircraft brakes. So due to this, the overall size of the component, so is saving 450 kgs of mass. So as we discussed that, the density of these components or these composites are very less. Due to that, 450 kgs of mass is reduced. So 4 times the durability with steel. 2 to 4 times. So if the steel material, the steel component, the life of the steel component is 1 year, the life of the carbon component will be 2 to 4 years. So 2 to 4 times the increasing durability is observed compared to the steel. Compared to steel, the durability is high. 2 to 4 times. Next, 2.5 times of specific heat of steel. So 2.5 times 2.5 times the specific heat of steel. So if we compare the operating conditions of the various materials, so if we want the operating conditions are in between or less than 400 degrees centigrade, then we will go for PMCs, that is polymer matrix composites. If it is around 400 degrees centigrade, the operating temperatures are less than 400 degrees centigrade, then we will go for polymer matrix composites. If the operating conditions are in between 1100 to room temperature, then we will go for metal matrix composites. That means various, if the operating temperature is around 400 degrees centigrade, then we will go for aluminum. If it is some more high, then we will go for stainless steel. If the operating temperature is some more high, then we will go for super alloys. So depends upon the application temperature. So it means depends upon the operating temperature. So depends upon this operating temperature, we are using different materials to withstand for that application. So similarly, if the operating temperatures are some more high, then we will go for ceramic matrix composites. So again, if the temperature is around 1200 degrees centigrade, if it is around 1200 degrees centigrade, then we will use silicon nitride or silicon carbide. So if it is more than that, then we will go for alumina. So earlier we discussed that aluminium and alumina both are different. Alumina is a ceramic composite component, whereas aluminium is a metal component. Is that here aluminium is metal material, whereas alumina is ceramic material. If the operating conditions are beyond that, then we will go for carbon composites. Carbon composites. Here the matrix is carbon, whereas the reinforcement is also the matrix material. Then we will go for carbon materials. If it is around 1600 degrees, then we will go for carbon materials. And if it is beyond that, then we will go for graphite. So this is the picture that depends upon the application. It means depends upon the operating temperature. We can use different materials. So this is one more example of carbon-carbon composites. So here the turbine blade is made up of carbon material with an epoxy. So here it's a polymer. Epoxy is the polymer and carbon is the fiber. The reinforcement is carbon and the matrix is epoxy. So similarly here all the elements are made up of carbon fibers. So all the metals are the reinforcements are carbon materials and the matrix materials are varied depends upon the application. So this is one more application of our carbon fibers. So here the carbon fibers are in black color. Those are surrounded with a polymer matrix so that the carbon fibers can be easily seen by us.